Hello and welcome to yet another Wondershare recovery video. Today I'll be addressing a common headache for Windows users, the persistent issue of the C drive filling up, and sometimes even without a trace. The C drive, often referred to as the system drive, houses a lot of apps and services. This makes it possible for your computer to run smoothly. But before we get into the details about all of this, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, we'd love to hear your experiences of any drive issues you're having. We know you all have different stories to tell. And without further ado, let's start fixing computers. The C drive, your computer's go-to storage for system files, Windows updates, and temporary data, tends to get a bit crowded over time. To give your C drive a breath of fresh air, we'll be leveraging the power of the disk cleanup tool. The steps I'm about to show you should help you free up some valuable space and get your computer working smoothly. Click on the Windows search icon located in the taskbar, type disk cleanup, and hit enter. A window will pop up. From the drop-down menu, select the C drive and click OK. Now, under the Files to Delete option, use the checkboxes to choose the files that you want to bid farewell to. Once you've made your selections, click OK to proceed. Then, for the grand finale, click the Delete Files button to confirm your decision and watch those unnecessary files vanish, creating space for your computer to breathe. This should free up some space and allow the drive to work more effectively. But sometimes the problem goes beyond this, and this brings us to method number two. Disk cleanup is a really helpful tool, but wouldn't it be great if Windows could do it all for you automatically? So let me show you how StorageSense can help keep your C drive organized and free up some space. By following these easy steps that I'm about to show you, your computer should not show these pop-up errors again. All you need to do is go to the Settings app by pressing the Windows key and I, then navigate to System on the left sidebar and click on Storage from the right panel. Click on StorageSense and then under the Cleanup of Temporary Files option, check the box that says Keep Windows running smoothly by automatically cleaning up the temporary system and app files. You can also turn on the Automatic User Content Cleanup option for an extra layer of tidying. And take control of StorageSense's schedule. Use the drop-down menu to select how often it should run. Every day, every week, every month, or just when there is low free disk space. I like to take things a little too far. I really hate it when an error pops up on my computer, so if I'm using this method, the Enable StorageSense method, I will use what I call the optional extra magic. All you need to do here is configure StorageSense to clean up the recycle bin and the download folders regularly. With StorageSense enabled, your Windows PC will gracefully handle the cleanup, ensuring that your C drive stays clutter-free. But you can also go for a more reliable method, and that takes us to method number three. System Restore is a handy tool that makes a copy of your system whenever it detects any big changes. But if you allocate too much space to the System Restore points, it can fill up your C drive on your Windows 10 and 11 computers. To prevent this from happening, you can reduce the amount of storage space that is set aside for System Restore points. When you do this, Windows will end up replacing old restore points rather than making new ones. And the best part about using this method is that it's very simple. All you need to do is go to your System Restore settings by typing Create a Restore Point in the Windows search bar and then press Enter. Under the System Protection tab, locate your beloved local disk C and click on the Configure button. From here, you should have full control of your device. Drag the max usage slider to the left, click Apply, and seal the deal by clicking OK. By adjusting the disk space allocated to System Restore, you ensure that Windows doesn't go overboard creating new restore points. Your C drive will still have room to function effectively and your system will still be protected. You can also try out method number four. By default, Windows automatically stores all apps and downloads from the Microsoft Store on your C drive. And here's another reason why your C drive might get very full. To avoid this, you can modify the default location where apps, music, photos, documents, and other files are saved. To begin, let's open the Start menu. Look for the icon that looks like a cog, this represents the settings, and click on it to open. Navigate to the System tab and then click on Storage. To access the storage management section, locate the option Advanced Storage Settings and click on the downward arrow next to it. This will expand the section and show you more options. Choose the option Where New Content is Saved, then use the drop-down menu next to each file type and select a different drive, then click on Apply. By following these steps, you should have your computer free of annoying C drive errors. And since we use the internet and install external hard drives to our computers, sometimes the problem might be bigger than what we've discussed so far. I really don't like to deal with extreme cases, but you might be dealing with a malware or a virus. And that brings us to the last method. Sometimes bad software called malware, like viruses or ransomware, can make your C drive get really full with data. If you're still having issues even after trying some of the other methods we've shown you so far, you might want to think about scanning your computer for malware using Windows Defender. Windows Defender is pre-installed on your Windows 10 and 11 systems. To access it easily, you should just type Windows Security in the search bar and hit Enter. Once you're in the Windows and Security app, locate and click on Virus and Threat Protection in the sidebar. Now hit Quick Scan to swiftly scan the most vulnerable areas of your system for any lurking malware. For a more thorough investigation, opt for a full scan. This may take longer, but it guarantees that no stone is left unturned. Now, if Windows Defender detects any mischievous malware, you can proceed to the removal phase. Follow the prompts on screen and click Start Actions to let Windows Defender quarantine or remove the identified threats. Your system should now be free from any sort of malware. Click OK and resume using your computer. And with that, we've come to the end of the video. I hope you found these 5 methods useful. And before you leave, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you don't miss any of our future videos. And thank you for watching.